And today I have a little project that I'm gonna do. I found this little bucket at one of our local thrift stores here, and I'm going to paint this. What I'm going to use it for is that I get all that stuff from McDonald's and Burger King and, you know, any of our fast food restaurants that we go to, and I put them in the cabinet and they just lay there and they're all over the place. So I thought this was cute and I could put it in there, but I like it white because my goes with my stuff instead of keeping it yellow. So I'm going to paint it, and I got some sandpaper here. I got it at Dollar General. Of course I'm not going to use all this, but you know, this is the only size I could get. You don't need anything fancy for it, just to smooth it down, to because it's glossy. And I got me some of this paint. I've already had it, so we're going to use this, and I'll take this outside to do this part, and then once it's all painted, then we'll come back and see how it looks. So stay tuned. I'm going to sand it first, sand it down, and then I'll come back. Okay guys, so I sanded it down the best I could. Hopefully this will work. I mean, it's for plastic, this paint, so I think, and it's got primer in it, so I think it'll be just fine. So Shaver had a good idea, and it has lines on here, so he said, why don't you leave the lines yellow and paint the rest? And I was like, okay. So I got some tape and we're gonna tape the things yellow on top so I don't get paint all over them. And what I'm gonna do, I gotta cut this is wide, so it'll be too wide for that little line, so I'm gonna put it in half as best as I can. And I washed it with a paper towel, damp paper towel, and then I dried it. So yes, after you sand it down, I didn't show you the sanding part because everybody knows how to do that, right? So it's just a little bit of sanding, and so you get the glossy part off as much as you can. I mean, I still have some on there, but you know, it's just hard to get it all off, especially when it's around the handles and stuff. So I'm just trying to see how I might cut some of this off still. Yeah, because it's pretty wide, so I just want to get some of it off. Ooh, I made it too thin. Because you just want to cover the line, you know. You don't want to. So if you find, go to your thrift store and you find these little black baskets or something, you know, I was like, well, let me look and see if they have something that I could use, you know. Because I was going to go to Dollar Tree and find some, and I was like, well, we were in there, so we like to go in there every once in a while to see what's new. We don't go out of there too much because it's usually the same stuff. You got to wait a little bit, and then we go back, and we hadn't been in there a long time, so I was like, let's go in there. We had to go to Lowe's, so on our way back, we went in there, and yeah, it was okay. So I found this little basket for 88 cents. Not too bad. I think these are probably a Dollar Tree. They're probably $1.25 now. So, you know. I didn't want anything expensive. You know, I don't want to pay a bunch of money for just a little bucket. Excuse me. so she bears out there making his video on the Corvette. We got the injectors, yes, today. We got them today, but it is very hot outside. It's 97 degrees out there right now, and the heat index is like 109. So they're telling everybody to stay inside in the air conditioning and not to go out unless you absolutely have to. So I told him not to do the injectors today. I know he wants to do it because he's really anxious about getting the Corvette running. Me too. It'll be nice to be able to even just be able to move it around in the yard so I can get it on my driveway. It's been there 2 years. So yeah, hard to believe it's been 2 years already, but yeah, so it'll be nice to be able to move it around. Yeah, I think he wants to move the truck up closer to the garage so he can work on it, because he's gonna take it apart and all that good stuff. And we're gonna have pretty much a new motor by the time he finishes. So that'll be nice, because that truck really deserves it. It's worked really hard for us, and well, for me and him. And it took him back and forth to work, and it made lots of money for me, for my job, and it deserves it. It's a very good truck. I don't think I ever had a better vehicle. I really don't. I had a lot of broken ones, that's for sure. So, I'm just kind of trying to just cover the line so I can paint it, and then we'll get it outside. And I'm going to thin this out, though. It's a little bit too much. And just put it on top here. That's all I'm trying to do. And trying to make it as thin, you know, I don't want it where it can't paint. And then I'll have yellow sticking through in certain spots. And if this doesn't work out, I'll just paint over it. But he thought it looked pretty. So I was like, yeah, sure, I can do that. See here, get this going. Sorry, I'm sticking. So I can't believe it's really hot. Now we're gonna pay for it, because this was a really nice spring we had this year, really nice, and now we're gonna pay for it. So it's going to be a very, very hot summer, I think. So, anyways, almost got it. One little piece there, and I'll take this outside, and I'm going to spray the inside, and I'm also going to spray the outside. So, I can bring you along for a little bit of it, if you like. So you can get a gist of what I'm doing. There you go. There. So.
Someone is detected at your front door.
That's Shaver. He's out front. So. And I want to cover this one little piece because it's part of the line there. To cover the line, you don't want it to cover the bucket, all of it, because then you can't get paint on there, you know what I mean? So, it's kind of hard to do a little bit, because, you know, if I have it lift over too much, you see the line's right here, So if I have it over, then that's going to be yellow. And I want it white. So, anyways, we'll see how it works out. There we go. So we're going to go outside now. And I'm going to show you my first spray paint. I'll show it to you. I'll probably put two coats on it. Most of the time I do with most of my stuff, so I think that would work out. So let's go outside and let's paint. Okay guys, you're here in the air conditioner. We are outside. I'm on my table here. I'm shaking it up. Shake, shake, shake. Make sure it's good and shake. And then we'll spray paint it. Do the outside first, I guess. Maybe. Put gloves on. I don't want it all over me. Hopefully it won't. I got a dress on today. I had to go to my mom's doctor's office and get a cup papers for a procedure that she's going to have done. So she's going to have that. And they had called me, so I had to go down there and then I had to go to the store. So. It's so hot out, I just flipped on anything. Okay. There we go. Pretty good. Then take about a few minutes. Yep. And I'm going to let this dry for right now. And then when we get it dried, I will do another coat and then we'll flip it upside down. And we'll do the bottom part. You don't have to do the bottom, but that's up to you. I like to have it completely finished, you know. So it should be all right. So we'll be back after it gets dried. Okay guys, so I gave it a couple of coats of paint and it's still tacky. It is tacky a little bit, but it's drying. I brought it in because it's so hot outside. I might have to do some touch up on it. See, that's what I was afraid of right there, because when you do that with that, you know, it's just going to take some of that paint off. So I might have to spray up there tomorrow and do a little touch up on it. But let me see if I can get this stuff off. Because I don't want to leave it on too long. Excuse me. It's so hot outside. It's unreal. So it is summer, even though it's not summer yet, but, yeah. So, we're going to take it off, and we'll see what we get here. Hopefully you can see this. I'm trying to take this off. That's the only bad thing about doing that. I mean, it's a cute idea. I think it's cute, but yeah. I don't know if I like that at all. To me, it just kind of doesn't do what I want it to do. So. Some of the stuff off here. Well, it didn't do real bad. No, it's not horrible, horrible. It is kind of cute with the line there. I may touch it and clean it up, let it dry really good overnight. And then I'll touch it up a little bit the best I can. And scrape it off where it doesn't need to be. You know, so it looks a little more even. That's what I'm going to do. The inside looks pretty good, and that's what it looks like. So, you know, I mean, it's going to be in the cupboard, but I kind of wanted it a little bit better than that. You know what I mean? So, I'll play with it again tomorrow a little bit, and we'll see how well it works tomorrow, okay? So, we'll let it dry, and because it's still tacky, and scrape this paint where it needs to be scraped and touch it up a little bit and see if we can make it look a little bit better. Okay, but that's it for tonight, and we'll just let it be. Let it be, let it be. Just let it dry. Oh, I'm sticking. And just let it dry. So, you know, if you want to do something like this, I don't know if I do the line thing though. I mean, it's cute. It makes it cute. But it also makes a mess. So, you know, if I just painted it all one color, then it wouldn't have been like that. So, I don't know if I want to just paint over it. I don't know. I might just do that and just paint over it. Because it really kind of didn't work the way I wanted it to go. But we'll play with it again tomorrow, and I'll bring you back, and we'll finish this off, okay? So have a good evening, and we'll see you tomorrow. Hey everyone, this is Monkey 1000, and I finally finished it. I didn't do what I wanted to do. I did try. I put more tape on here, and I cut it, made it real thin. Then I painted it last night, and I didn't like it. So, I gave up on it, and I just painted the whole thing white. So, that's what happened. I'm not happy, but, you know, things happen, right? So, if you want to try it, you can, you know, put a line if you want and try to do it yourself. But it just didn't work out for this bucket. I don't know why, but it just didn't. So anyways, it's going to be in the cupboard. It did have a little flaws in here because I did try so much and gave up on it. So anyways, so hopefully this will work out really good. I'll put these in here just like so. If we get any more, I'll buy them and just throw them in here. And I hopefully, because I did this, that it will basically, you know, be used. You know, these will get used instead of thrown out. So, yeah. So, there you go. And it took me 3 days to do this because I had such a problem with the line. So, I guess I should have just painted it white all together. It would have been a lot easier. So, anyways, that's it for now. Monkey says she's out, and I hope you liked the video. I know, it was a flaw, really, but, you know, things happen, right? And I don't want to, you know, not put it up because, you know, it didn't work out. So I want you to know everybody's human and we have mistakes. We do mistakes. So it is what it is. So, and I still have it white just like I wanted. So I'm happy with it, I guess. I'm fine. Anyways, that's it for now. Monkey says she's out. Bye, y'all. Hey everyone, this is Monkey 1000, and today I have a little project that I've got to do. That's my phone, sorry. That I'm going to do. I found this little bucket right here for 88 cents. We went to the thrift store one day, Shea Bear and I, and I found this, and I get all those stuff, you know, from McDonald's and Burger King. And
someone was detected at your front door.
Oh my God.